what time it is? It's time for KP's video news.
That's right, folks. Time for KP's video news, y'all. And this is like a news flash. News flash, news flash. News flash, news flash. Kim Potter, shooter of Daunte Wright, has been found guilty of manslaughter in the death of Daunte Wright and former Brooklyn Center police officer. Kim Potter has been found guilty of first degree and second degree manslaughter in the fatal shooting of Daunte Wright. Potter had pleaded not guilty. The maximum sentence for first degree manslaughter is 15 years and a $30,000 fine, and second degree manslaughter is a 10-year $20,000 fine. She got found guilty on both charges, first and second degree, similar to what happened with Derek Chauvin in the George Floyd situation. And so you got in a statement, let's see, the Wright family's legal team said the family is relieved and they called for reform and changes America's policing policies and the unnecessary and overreaching tragic traffic stop and the shooting that took his life, and that day will remain a traumatic one for his family and yet another example of America, of why we desperately need to change in policing, training and protocols, the statement read. And if we ever going to restore the confidence of the black and marginalized Americans in law enforcement, we need to have accountability and a commitment to listening to and creating a meaningful change and meaningful dialogue. And Potter, alongside another other Brooklyn Center Minneapolis, that's Minnesota officers, pull Wright over for expired registration tags and an air freshener on the rearview mirror. When officers discovered he had an outstanding warrant for gross misdemeanor, a weapons charge, they tried to arrest him, according to the police testimony at trial, and he resisted and attempted to re-enter his vehicle when Potter shot him. He then drove away, crashing shortly after. Potter's defense team has maintained that Wright's death was an accident throughout the trial. They said Potter mistakenly grabbed a gun instead of the stun gun, but that she was within her rights to use deadly force because Wright may have hurt another officer. Prosecutor said the 26-year-old veteran and training officer should not have reached for a stun gun in the first place. They assert that she was reckless and negligent in her actions. Potter testified on her own defense, sobbing on the witness stand as she recalled the events. And so, I mean, you got a lot of people, man. Every time you turn around, man, there's somebody that they're crying on the witness stand. You know, they're all crying on the witness stand. So anyway, you had, following the conviction, Attorney General Keith Ellison, the Wright family and the prosecution held a press conference to honor Wright's life. They said that we have a degree of accountability for Daunte's death. Accountability is not justice, Ellison said today, and justice is restoration. Justice would be restoring Daunte to life and making the Wright family whole again. Justice is beyond the reach that we have in this life for Daunte. Ellison spoke to law enforcement officials about what he says is their responsibility as public safety enforcers. He said, "We hold you in high regard, and we also hold you to high standards." Ellison added, "We want you to uphold the highest ideals of our society and ideals of safety. And when a member of your profession is held accountable, it does not diminish you. In fact, it shows that the whole world, that those of you who enforce the law are willing to live by it." Potter, alongside other Brooklyn Center, Minnesota officers, you know, like I stated earlier, went to that, you know, went through that whole situation, man. You know, like I said, she got on the witness stand and cried. And all these people are crying. Why? Every time you turn around, somebody is on the witness stand crying here lately. That's about the fifth person that's been crying in the last month. So, you know, but the, you know, like I said, the Minnesota Attorney General is like, you know, they want to be do what they have to do, and the Daunte Wright's attorneys and the family responded to the verdict, and like I said, Potter, she was found guilty, but she had pleaded not guilty, and she took the stand and testified before the jury, breaking down in tears and recounted the shooting, eventually apologizing and insisting that she didn't want to hurt anybody during her emotional testimony. You know, but the maximum, like I said, maximum penalty for first degree manslaughter is 15 years. So we're going to see how much time they're going to actually give her. And so Potter's husband was there in court, and he was heard yelling, "I love you, Kim," as she was taken into custody, as former Brooklyn police officer Kim Potter was handcuffed and then escorted out of the courtroom on Thursday. And Potter's husband, Jeff, was heard, you know, like I said, yelling, "I love you." And Potter said, "I love you back." Potter was found guilty. But Daunte Wright's mother began to sob as the first guilty verdict was read. And the first verdict was read by Judge Regina Chu, who reporters heard Wright's parents take a deep breath and loud sighs with their hands as one. They all joined hands and was holding hands. And Bryant began to sob at the first guilty verdict. And following the reading of the second verdict, Wright family let out cries, according to another pool reporter. And former officer was found guilty. And but they said, not much emotion from Potter after the guilty verdict. And as the guilty verdict was read in the trial of the former police officer Kim Potter and a fatal shooting with Daunte Wright, she was read, she stood silently. Broder said, outside the Minneapolis courthouse, she did not cry. From what I saw from our vantage point, when the first count was read, the first degree manslaughter, she looked down. When the guilty verdict was read on the second count, she closed her eyes. But Potter was, you know, and then Broder went on to add that she did notice an emotional reaction to the verdict by Potter's defense team. And the defense team was like, you know, they reacted, but she didn't react. More reaction, notably from her defense attorney, Earl Gray, Broder said after the jury was excused, he sat down and at one point buried his head in his hands. And so the Blakely factors, and it's like how the Blakely factors could affect part of sentencing. And an analyst named Elliot Williams explained the Blakely factors and how they may factor in the sentencing after former Minnesota police officer Kim Potter was found guilty. I think they're going to have a hard time getting aggravating factors in here, but they're there. Now, number one, one will certainly be that the individual abused a position of trust. She was given a firearm and was a trained officer, he said. The maximum penalty, like I said before, being 15 years for the first 15 years for first degree and then 10 years for second degree. He said typically someone without a criminal history would get, I believe in Minnesota, around 7 years in the middle of that range. But we'll see what the prosecution will come forward with and how, you know, how amenable the judge is. And that's what Blakely factors are. They exist in virtually all criminal trials, things that make the crime, sort of lack of a better way to put it, worse on account of the circumstances of the crime or the circumstances of who the defendant is or was. So Kim Potter will be sentenced on February 18th, 2022 at 10 a.m., according to Judge Regina Chu and defense attorneys. and prosecution agreed on the date after the brief back and forth. And initially, the defense attorneys requested for Potter to be released on $100,000 bail, but Judge Chu denied the request, stating, "I cannot treat this case any different from than any other case." And the former Brooklyn police officer was handcuffed and escorted out of the courtroom. Chu said she would be ordering resistance investigation and report, and the judge denies attorney's request for Potter to be released. And we can't, she said, Gray told the judge that the Potter is a devout Catholic, arguing that she has deep roots in the community and her family's here, and there's no evidence that she would flee. So we respectfully ask to change of mind as to whether she needs to be incarcerated right now. And Judge Chu denied the request. And he said, I'm going to require that she be taken into custody and held without bail. And so Chu ordered Potter to be remanded without bail until her sentencing on February 18th, 2022. And then the judge also praised the jury in the Potter trial, said you did your duty. And after reading aloud the verdict in the Kim Potter trial, Hennepin County Fourth Circuit Judge Regina Chu reiterated that the 12 jury members served heroically in their duty, and the jury found Potter guilty of first degree, second degree manslaughter, fatally shooting Daunte Wright. And you said yes, even though you were in a pandemic with Omicron spreading through our community. You said yes, even though you had concerns about serving. Given the nature of the case, you said yes, even though you knew you would be sequestered during the deliberations and away from your loved ones. And you said yes, even though there was a chance that this case could have lasted past Christmas. You were willing to sacrifice much because you believe in the justice system. And Chu said she was very proud of the jury, and then went into deliberations, and each of you brought with your common sense. And Potter found guilty. So it's like, with these, you got four main differences. This is the four main differences between Potter's taser and a handgun. So, I mean, wow. And here are the four main differences. First of all, during the testimony, they had a special agent, Sam McGinnis, of the Minnesota Bureau of Criminal Apprehension, described the taser and gun differences in appearance, weight, and positioning on Potter's utility belt. McGinnis is a state investigative agent responsible for the reviewing police shootings. Potter is charged with first and second degree manslaughter, but he said here are the main differences. The appearance. A taser is yellow, the firearm is black, McGinnis said, adding that a taser also has a stock body compared to the Glock handgun. And the grip of the taser is also shorter and wider. The weight. It's number two, the weight. Potter's Glock handgun weighs 2.11 pounds, McGinnis said, compared to the taser, which will actually weigh less than a pound. McGinnis said that this meant the Glock with ammo weighed twice as much as the taser. The operation is point number four. McGinnis said that the weapons are fired different. The gun's trigger is curved while the taser's trigger is flat. The taser has an external, I guess, on and off switch, which the Glock does not have. So that means you have to turn the taser on in order for it to work. And according to point number four is the position. According to the photos McGinnis took of Potter after the shooting, he testified that she kept her firearm and taser on opposite sides of her body. Her firearm was on her dominant side, which you'd have to use on your right hand to draw, he said, noting that her holster had a snap retention system to keep the gun in its holster. The taser was on the left and required her to push a lever with her left hand in order to get it out. And minutes before recounting the shooting, Potter testified she had received a new taser bottle. before the shooting. It still was going to be in the same location. So, oh, God, man. I'm telling you, man, this is just pathetic. And it was really pathetic. And those are the pictures that you see. I put the pictures there that you can, so you can see the pictures of the taser, just between the taser and the handgun. It said one was 2.11 pounds for the handgun and less than a pound for the taser. And they're on opposite sides of the belt. One on the right side for the gun, on the left side for the taser. The taser has an on and off switch. The Glock doesn't. So it's a lot of differences, man. A lot of differences. And so I'm telling you, man. Yep. So, I mean, they had body cam footage. They had a bunch of stuff, man. But, you know, hey, it is what it is, folks. What you going to do, man? You know, bad boys, what you going to do when they come for you? You know, they out there.
Man, you know what time it is.
You know what time it is. That's right, folks. This was a news flash. Kim Potter found guilty of shooting Daunte Wright, guilty of first and second degree manslaughter, and she will be sentenced on February 18th, 2022. Peace.